Hello guys, welcome to the channel. We are back again with another project, and this time we will be implementing the control system of an automatic washing machine using Verilog HDL. The various real-life scenarios can be represented by finite state machines where the procedure can be broken into different steps or states, and the transition among these states are defined by the change of a particular parameter. For example, the vending machine, the automatic washing machine, and the traffic light control system all are example of finite state machine. So we have assigned the main stages of the process like the closed door, fill water, add detergent, cycle, drain, and spin as various states that can be implemented as state machine. And we have written the code and the test bench to observe the working of the machine using Xilinx ISE 14.7. Let's have a look on the state diagram of the washing machine. So as you can see, we have six different states: dip door, fill water, add detergent, cycle, drain water, spin. After that, the process will be completed. So first of all, you'll put the clothes in the washing machine and you'll close the lid or the door of the washing machine. Then you will give the power supply, and then the next step is to fill the water. So until the water is not filled, we will turn on the fill valve on to give the water supply, and after that we'll add detergent. So basically how the washing algorithm works is, basically first of all you will wash your clothes in soap, and then you will wash them in clean water, and then you'll drain it, spin it, and then you can take out the clothes. So as you can see, after the fill water we go to the add detergent state if the clothes were not soaked in soap previously. We'll add the soap or the detergent. We'll go to the cycle state. So the cycle state is basically the state where the drum of the washing machine will rotate using a motor, and the clothes will be washed. We'll then drain the water out, dirty water out, and then if the clothes were soaked in soap previously, then we'll give them a water wash again by filling again the water and not adding the detergent this time, and directly going to the cycle state. Then we'll again drain this dirty water, and then we'll go to the spin state. So the spin state is basically for drying the clothes. So a very good feature of the washing machines is that you can dry the clothes as well. So that will be done in the spin state, where we'll have a timer to see how much time we need to dry the clothes. And after that, after the spin timer is completed, the clothes will be dried and you can remove the clothes, or we can repeat the process if required. So here we have some detailed on how we can transition among different states. So the first state is the check door, where until the start and the door close variable are not set, then we cannot transition to the next state, which depicts that the door is not closed or the machine is not started. Once the door is closed and the machine is started, we'll go to the fill water state. So until the water is not filled, we will turn on the fill valve to give the water supply and fill the machine with water. So, and if the soap wash is not done, we have to add the detergent, and we'll go through the add detergent state to the cycle state. And if the soap wash is already done, then we'll directly go to the cycle state and complete the water wash. So we add the detergent here in this state, add detergent state, and we will remain in this state until the detergent is added. And we'll also, this means also that the soap wash step is done. So once the detergent is added, we'll go to the cycle state, which is basically washing the clothes. So we have a cycle timeout, and until the cycle timeout is not completed, we'll switch on the motor. And once the cycle timeout is completed, the motor will be turned off, and then we will go to the drain water state. So the water will be drained, the dirty water will be drained out of the machine, and if the water wash was not done, we again fill the water in the machine. This time we'll not add the detergent, we'll go directly to the cycle state. As you can see, the water wash will be high. We'll go directly to the cycle state and wash the clothes with clean water, and again we'll drain that dirty water out. So once both the soap wash and the water wash are done, we will drain out the dirty water and we'll go to the spin state. The spin state is basically for drying the clothes, and in the spin as well we will turn on the drain valve on to drain out the dirty water during the spin state. And once this spin timer is completed, the washing of the cloth is done and we can remove our cloth. So we have seen the state diagrams and we have learned how we can transition among the different states that we have for our project. And let's see the code in Xilinx ISE 14.7 along with the simulation. So here you can see the Xilinx ISE 14.7 on my device. So just a note, I was facing some issues while installing Xilinx ISE on Windows 11. So I had to install virtual machine on my device. So after installing the virtual machine on my device, I had to install Xilinx ISE there. If you are facing issues in Windows 11, then I'll recommend to use this to run the software on your device. So moving on to the code, we have the main module, which is the automatic washing machine here, and we have the input and the output port, as you can see. So since we had six different states, so we had to use at least three variables while assigning. So as you can see, I have assigned all the six states here. And also I have used current state and next state as two registers to facilitate the transition process. So the basic structure of the code is written using the case statement. So we'll see the current state. So as you can see, first of all, we'll check the check door state. We'll go to the check door, and if the machine is started and the door is closed, we'll go on to the fill water state from the check door state. And if either of these are not done, then we'll remain in the current state itself. So after the check door state, we will go to the fill water state, and until the water is filled here, we will remain in this state. And once the water is filled, we'll go to the next state. So the next state can be either add detergent or cycle, as I explained in the PPT. So if the soap wash is not done, we have to go to the add detergent state and the soap wash will be completed there. And if the soap wash is already done, that is if soap wash is done, we will come to this else part and we will directly go to the cycle state, which also depicts that the water wash is completed. And if the water is not filled, we will remain in the current state and we'll turn on the water fill valve to get the water supply. Next is the add detergent state, where we will add detergent. So once the detergent is added, we'll go to the next state, that is the cycle state, and wash the clothes. And if the detergent is not added, we'll remain in the current state. So next is the cycle state. So we have a timer, and once the cycle timeout is completed, we'll go to the next state, which is drain the water out. And if the timer is not completed, we'll remain in the current state and the motor will be turned on. So the next state is the drain water, where we'll drain the water out of the machine. And from here again, we can either go to the fill water state or we can go to the spin state. So if the water wash is not done, we'll go to the fill water state and facilitate the water wash sequence. And if the water wash is completed, this means that we can go to the spin state to dry the clothes. And if the If the water is not drained out, we will turn on the drain valve to drain out the water. So the next state is the spin state. So once this spinner timeout is completed, we will go to the initial state and our washing process is completed. As you can see here, done is set as high. And if it is not done, if the cycle timeout is not come, if the spin timeout is not completed, we'll remain in the current state. So this is the end case statement to define the ending of the case structure. So I have also written a basic test bench to observe the simulation. So you can also write your own test bench and play along to see how your washing machine runs. So let's see the simulation. So as you can see here in the initial, so in the initial part of the simulation itself, I have turned on the start and the door close variables or the inputs, and I have then filled the water, added the detergent, and as you can see, based on the different inputs, the output is also changed. Like here, the door close is set as door lock is set as high as soon as the machine is started and the door is closed, and the motor is turned on, the water is filled, the water is drained out, and so forth is done. The water wash is done. And as soon as all the stages are done, the done variable is finally set as high, as you can see here, which indicates that clothes have been washed. We have implemented the code on Verilog HDL using Xilinx ISE. You can implement the code on FPGA to demonstrate the code with hardware. And since this is an example of finite state machine, the code can be used as a basis to implement another finite state machines like traffic lights or vending machines, as well as I discussed earlier. And you can add more functionality to the washing machine, like something based on clothing material or temperature or any other thing you want to add. You can also add it here as a future scope. So thank you all for watching the video. I hope you like the video, and do share the video with your friends, like the video, and drop any queries in the comment section below, and you can connect with me on LinkedIn or drop me an email. Thank you everyone for watching. Goodbye.